network, which is Equalities in Public-Private Partnerships, is a network that started last year, but the way it came about was we had a workshop the year before in 2015 in London, where colleagues from India, Shalman and Pranjal were at the network, at the workshop with colleagues from South Africa, who unfortunately can't be here today. And we had an event around public-private partnerships, and we decided at that workshop that we'd look for other ways to continue this work together and build on the themes that we'd sort of talked about in the initial workshop in London. And we put in for this bid, and we were successful. So and it's great because the funds have been able to give us the opportunity to build on that work, and we've had we're a year in now, but to sort of have this year and a half that the funding is to really kind of try to identify some common themes and issues and problems around public-private partnerships in India and South Africa. And so the idea of the network is to bring researchers together to look at public-private partnerships across health, education, water and housing in the two countries, and to try and identify both cross-sectoral lessons, so, you know, are there parallels, are there differences in the four sectors, but also what kind of trends we can identify across the countries and what are the differences. And the idea is also that the two countries, so India and South Africa, operate as regional hubs. And it's great that we've had this opportunity today, and we had a similar workshop in South Africa in Cape Town in November, where we tried to work with colleagues from different regional universities as well, and to really sort of see what's going on. One of the things we hope to do today is to sort of build on some of the learning from South Africa, and as Pranjal mentioned, Elaine Unterholter talked about the public good, but sort of trying to think about how that, you know, what the relevance is in the Indian context and how that plays into the, or doesn't play into the debate around public-private partnerships. And then our final network meeting will be in June 2018 in Brussels, and we really hope there that, you know, all the learning from today and from Cape Town, that we'll be able to sort of bring it together and come up with some, well, not final, but final conclusions from our network that will hopefully lead on to other future activities. One of the main focuses of the network is on inequalities, and I think we need to kind of hopefully be able to keep that at the centre of our discussions today, and to try and understand how PPPs in the four sectors impact on inequalities, and obviously income and class inequalities, but also gender, race, caste, ethnicity, age, and all these axes of inequalities, and how they intersect and play out, and how they're manifest in the different sectors. And, you know, do PPPs impact on inequalities in the same way across the sectors, or are there differences? And do we see kind of comparable trends in India and South Asia as we do in South Africa and other parts of sub-Saharan Africa? You know, what kind of parallels can we find, and where are the key differences? And as Pranjal mentioned, you know, we're very interested in the idea of the public good, because I think one of the things that we've discussed is, well, if we're talking about, you know, what are we talking about, a return to the public sector? And if we are, you know, what do we mean by that? What do we mean by the public? And in the same way, you know, we've been trying to unpack what we mean by the private. And are we, when we talk about PPPs, are we all talking about the same things? Because I think it's come out already in some of our earlier discussions that actually the way, for example, PPPs are talked about in the health sector has got differences to the way in which it's talked about in the other sectors. So I think it would be good to explore that more today and tomorrow, and see, you know, are we all using the same language, or are we coming at this from very different starting points? And if so, what does that mean for our understanding of the issues? And one of the other points we're interested in trying to identify is, you know, what are the policy drivers in the different countries? Is this shift towards PPPs, can we talk about this kind of global push towards PPPs, or are there very different political contexts in the different countries that are supporting this drive, and who are the actors that are kind of opposing the shift towards PPPs? And do we see you know, comparable actors in the different countries. So again, I think these are interesting questions, and perhaps tomorrow at the end we can sort of reflect on some of these things and look at, you know, what we could identify here. And I think again in South Africa, one of the things that came out quite clearly from the discussion is, you know, are we even talking about the same actors? And I think in the discussion there, I imagine today and tomorrow, it starts to emerge that there are actors such as Netcare Hospital, who provide hospitals, and Bridge Academies in the education sector, who are actually who operate in both the Indian and the South African context. You know, so we are starting to identify that these are the same private sector actors who are at work in both our country contexts. So, you know, that leads to questions about, you know, what is the history of the emergence of PPPs in the two countries, regions, and how has that played out, and where are these influences coming from, and, you know, how is it that Netcare can operate in both India and South Africa and the UK, and how is it that Bridge Academies are able to operate in both these very different country contexts? And again, we're interested in how PPPs work in practice, and I think, you know, it looks like we've got a very rich agenda today and tomorrow, and I think some of that will come out much more clearly today. And also another really important part of the network is around capacity building, and we've been working with PhD students in both South Africa and here, and we've got three PhD students here today who are going to be presenting their work, and that's been an integral part of the network, the idea that you know, we're going to be working with PhD students, hopefully publishing with our PhD students as the network draws to a close, and looking to build on sharing that knowledge beyond the kind of key people in the network. So I'm really pleased that you three are here today, and I'm sure you'll make a really important contribution to the network. So, thank you all for being here, and thank you for hosting us, Brandon.